بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our question today or our case today is very interesting. Common Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board and Egyptian board. We'll see our case here. The following cause the onset of persistent vomiting in 3 weeks old male. Actually, this clue in this question, you can diagnose what is the lesion or what is the disease with this baby. He said persistent vomiting or continuous vomiting or projectile vomiting in 3 weeks, the time or age specific diagnosis, the onset of the disease, and male is because this disease it will be common in male rather than in female. So persistent non-projectile vomiting in 3 weeks old male, قولا واحدا, congenital hypertrophic infantile pyloric stenosis. Why 3 weeks? Because actually the muscle contraction, it will take time to be hypertrophied. It will take time. So the pyloric stenosis cannot present in the first week or second week. Can be, but actually rare. But its common presentation, it will be the 3 weeks until the muscle, it will be hypertrophied from the contraction. Hypertrophied from contraction. Male, because 4 to 5 times, common in male rather than female, and the vomitus it will be non-actual bilious projectile or persistent non-bilious vomiting. Projectile non-bilious vomiting in 3 weeks old male patient, pyloric stenosis until proven otherwise. Pyloric stenosis until proven otherwise, or it will give you clue this is pyloric stenosis or suggest pyloric stenosis. Suggest pyloric based on what? Based on the clinical history and examination and the laboratory and the imaging, the age specific presentation, this is the 3 weeks to 3 months, and also the sex or the gender of the baby, it's common in the male, and the type of the vomiting, non-pilious and projectile. You see, projectile, and the baby it will be hunger after the vomiting, after that vomiting. And you see the baby clinically, the baby is cachexic, dehydrated, lost weight, looks like failure to thrive. You see, the baby is dehydrated, jaundice, cachexic, losing weight. Because why jaundice? Because decreased activity of glucuronide transferase enzyme, and also it will be increase the enterohepatic circulation. This patient having vomiting, so he lost what? He will lose hydrogen and chloride, so it will be hypokalemic metabolic alkalosis. We'll see here, this is A, disaccharidase intolerance, it will be acidosis rather than alkalosis. Duodenal atresia, it will be earlier presentation rather than in pyloric stenosis, it will be in the 3 weeks to 3 months. This is pyloric stenosis, this is classic pyloric stenosis. Based on what? Based on the clinically and laboratory and imaging. Clinically, the age specific presentation, the gender of the baby, and the type of the vomiting is projectile or non-bilious or persistent vomiting. And you'll see the patient in the clinical situation, baby is what? Dehydrated, jaundice, ecteric, and can lead to hypoperfusion and shock or hypovolemia. So the hiatus hernia, actually this is not the time of the presentation. Lactose intolerance, it will be presented with acidosis. So this is the pyloric stenosis, congenital, hypertrophic, infantile, colchips, pyloric stenosis. You see here, this is the pylorus. There is contraction related to hypertrophy of the muscle. The muscle, it will be sickness. It was the normal sickness less than 2 millimeter. But in the pyloric stenosis, the thickness of this muscle or the circularis and the longitudinal muscle of the pylorus, it will be more than 4 millimeter and elongated. It will be string like it will be string sign, it will be elongated, it will be 14 millimeter, four, rule of four, 4 millimeter the thickness of the canal or the channel of the pylorus, and also the elongated more than 14. You see here, this is the age specific presentation. It's very nice slide and very helpful actually slide for answering the MCQ, or can help you in your practice even to exclude the cases. Our case here, if you see pyloric stenosis between what? Between 3 weeks to 3 months. but the early presentation less than 1 month, you see the first one malrotation, especially full term baby, and neck, it will be premature babies and Hirschsprung, it will be also, it will be vomiting and failure to pass stool, it will be also in the presentation, it will be earlier here between 3 weeks to 3 months pyloric stenosis, and between 1 month to 2 years intussusception appendicitis, it will be more than 2 years. Here, why is CHIPS congenital, hypertrophic, infantile, pyloric stenosis? Because by there is non-bilious projectile vomiting, and also the age specific presentation 3 weeks to 3 months, and also if you examine the baby, there is palpable mass. Why is this palpable? This is the hypertrophic muscle. You are palpating the hypertrophic muscle in the epigastric area, and this is the ultrasound. If you see here, the thickness of the pyloric muscle, it will be 4 millimeter, and the elongations, the measure of the long canal or channel, it will be more than 14 millimeter. This is the clinical assessment. The baby history, it will be between 3 weeks to 3 months, three, like the ultrasound, it will be 4 millimeter. This is the thickness, and the elongation, it will be 14 millimeter. So the presentation, it will be between age specific presentation 3 weeks to 3 months. The type of the vomiting, it will be projectile resistance, non-bilious vomiting, especially after the feeding, immediately within 3 to 6 minutes, the patient, it will vomit. For sure, the baby is vomiting, he is not actually take calories, so is leading to weight loss. Baby is vomiting, dehydrations. If not actually treat this dehydration, leading to what? Hypoperfusion, hypovolemia, hypotension. Patient can be came with dehydrated shock, and also resistant hunger. The patient, if after he vomit, he need more. His hunger, he didn't take anything actually. The baby is still hunger. Jaundice 2%. Why? Due to decreased hepatic glucuronide transferase associated with starvation due to increased intrahepatic circulation. With any intestinal obstruction, it will increase the intrahepatic circulation, leading to jaundice and icterus. The baby, you see, baby is cachexic, dehydrated, icteric, can lead to hypoperfusion, hypovolemia. If you examine this baby, there is 2B, palpable olive mass. Why is this palpable olive mass? Due to hypertrophy the pyloric muscle. Where can I palpate this one? In the epigastric area or right epigastric area. It will be in the epigastric area or right epigastric. You see here, if you see here, you see here, epigastric, in the epigastric area, here in the epigastric area or para epigastric area. And visible gastric peristalsis. يسموها الحركة الدودية بريستالسيز. There is right it will be visible gastric بريستالسيز from left upper quadrant to epigastric. From left تيجي من الشمال تروح على epigastric على السنتر. From left upper quadrant to epigastric. So in the epigastric you can palpate the mass due to hypertrophied. This is the mass of the hypertrophied muscle due to contraction. And you can see or visible to you, this is inspection, it will see the left upper quadrant to epigastric. There is peristaltic movement. You can see it from the left up to, from the left up to the epigastric. Actually, if you will see in front of you, it will be right for you, but it will be from left to epigastrium. From left to epigastrium, the baby, it will be ectric and dehydrated. Can sometimes it will be hypoperfuse or hypovolemic shock. So clinical examination, inspection, palpation. Inspection, visible peristalsis move from where? From left upper quadrant epigastric, upper quadrant to epigastric. And you can palpate what? Mass. This is 1.5 to 2 centimeter in the right epigastric area or in epigastric area. So by history and clinical assessment, this is the laboratory assessment. Laboratory assessment, the patient is vomiting. So what will happen with the vomiting? It will lose hydrogen and losing what? Chloride. If you lose hydrogen and chloride, what will happen? It will be, if you request for electrolytes, it will be hypochloremic, hypokalemic metabolic alkalosis. Hypochloremic, hypokalemic metabolic alkalosis. They may be having projectile vomiting, resistant vomiting. So the extracellular fluid volume, it will be deficit. Hypoperfusion, hypovolemia lead to urinary excretion. It will be salt and water retention and hydrogen potassium excretion to restore the circulation, to restore this hypovolemia. So it will salt and water retention and hydrogen and potassium excretion. Hydrogen and potassium excretion lead to alkalosis and hypokalemia, and salt and water retention to restore the volume, to restore the volume, and leading to what will happen for the urinary excretion of the potassium to preserve the sodium and water. Initially it will be alkalotic urine and become acidotic. We call it paradoxical aciduria. Paradoxical, this classic for biliary stenosis, it will be paradoxical aciduria. Aciduria. So the clinical manifestation, the baby will be ectric and dehydrated. And there is inspection, it can see the peristaltic movement, and by palpation you can palpate the muscle in the epigastric area. Clinical, this is clinical. Laboratory, it will be the baby hypochloremic, hypokalemic metabolic alkalosis with paradoxical aciduria with secondary respiratory acidosis. Hyponatremia may not be evident actually because hypovolemia. How to diagnose? History, clinical examination, laboratory, and abdominal ultrasound. Abdominal ultrasound, the pyloric muscle thickness, it will be more than what? 4 millimeters. The normal how much? 2. Less than 2. And the length, this is the العرض أكثر من 4. الطول أكثر من 14. الطول في العرض. الطول في العرض. يبقى العرض, the thickness of the pyloric muscle, more than 4 millimeters. Normal, less than 2 millimeter. But in the length of the pyloric lens, it will be more than 14 millimeter. Normal, less than 10. Less than 10. This is the normal. So upper GI, when you can request upper GI for in pyloric stenosis, if a typical presentation or negative ultrasound, but still you are doubt about the pyloric stenosis and ultrasound it was negative, you have to request for what? Upper GI study for a typical presentation of pyloric stenosis or negative ultrasound. So diagnosis, it will be narrowing elongated pyloric channel with pyloric mass effect on the stomach and duodenum, with pyloric channel. It will be pyloric mass effect. We call it mass effect because it's hypertrophied. The pylorus, it will be hypertrophied. So there is pyloric mass effect where? In the stomach. It will be in the stomach, lead to projectile vomiting and the duodenum also, it's so lead to non-bilious because compress the duodenum and the ampulla of Futter. This is the area of the pile, it will be secreted in the duodenum. So it's actually there is a mass effect on the duodenum, so the vomiting, it will be non-bilious, and also it will be projectile because it's compressed on the stomach, compression of the stomach. So, and also it will give you specific sign, call it a string sign. String sign, what is the meaning of string sign? خيط, زي الخيط. Or double track, it will be give you also double track, or peak, زي من أر الطائر, or pyloric teeth sign. Pyloric teeth sign. This is the sign. Call it علامة الخيط, علامة الخيط, أو منقار الطائر. Here, علامة الخيط. شايف علامة الخيط اهي. Because pyloric stenosis, it will be elongated channel more than 14 millimeter, and the thickness, it will be more than 4 millimeter. So it will compress the duodenum and the stomach, lead to projectile vomiting and non-bilious vomiting. It will give you sign. What is this sign? We call it string sign, علامة الخيط, أو peak sign. Peak sign. This is, you see, this is the normal. This is the normal stomach. You see, this is, you see, this is normal stomach and pylorus here. You see, this is the normal. What happened? String sign. String sign. How, what is the differential diagnosis? It will, for sure, any vomiting, you have to rule out gastroesophageal reflux. This is common with or without hiatal hernia. With or without hiatal hernia. Why this patient is not gastroesophageal reflux? Because the presentation, age-specific presentation, and also the radiological finding is suggestive. It will be suggestive pyloric stenosis, and amount of the vomitus. The vomitus, it will be small, but in the pyloric stenosis is projectile, large projectile vomiting, and the infant does not usually lose weight. The gastroesophageal reflux, there's two important points. The weight, the weight, it will not loss in the gastroesophageal reflux, and also the developmental milestone, it will be normal with reflux. But in the baby with bilateral stenosis, he will lose weight, it will be cachexic, ectoric, dehydrated, hypovolemic, and the milestone, developmental milestone, it will be affected because the baby will be cachexic and dehydrated, ectoric. But in the gastroesophageal reflux, it will be a small amount, and the weight was normal, and developmental milestone was normal. Why is not adrenal insufficiency? It will be by laboratory investigation, because the presentation will be same, vomiting, and the patient can present with dehydration or shock. It will be deep rapid respiration because the acidosis. The differentiation, it will be what? Metabolic acidosis. Metabolic acidosis and what? Hyperkalemia and elevated urinary sodium. The bilateral stenosis, hypocaloremic, hypokalemic metabolic alkalosis. In the adrenal insufficiency, it will be metabolic hyperkalemia and hyponatremia and metabolic acidosis and hypoglycemia for sure, and hypoglycemia. Why is not viral gastroenteritis? Because what? Because the presentation or the time of the presentation, and it will be associated with diarrhea and sickness. How to treat this patient? This is medical emergency, is not surgical emergency. This is medical emergency, but not surgical emergency. Definitive treatment, it will be bilouromyotomy. Bilouro, this means bilorus. Myo, this is the muscle. Otomy, you make a dissection or you release the stenosis. You release to stenosis. And for sure, you have what is the general management of the surgical cases or intestinal obstruction? 5N. NPO, NGT free drainage, it will be big poor NGT to avoid the aspiration and to deflate the stomach, to decompress the stomach and to ventilate the stomach to prevent the aspirations. And you have to normalize normal saline. It will give to, because the patient is dehydrated, so you have to give rehydration for this baby and to treat the electrolyte disturbance. So this is normal saline boluses, then you give the maintenance and can you give shock therapy based on the condition of the baby or the degree of the dehydration or if the patient in shock. So give normal saline or replacement therapy or rehydration of the baby. So NBO, NGT free drainage to prevent the aspirations, and also the normal saline as case of fluid. You have to give fluid, replacement therapy fluid for rehydrations to treat the dehydration and treat the shock, and you have to treat the acid, call it electrolyte acid base balance, electrolyte acid base balance. For N, it will be notify the surgeon. You have to notify the surgeon. I have baby with projectile vomiting and non-bilious vomiting and 3 weeks and male. The most probably it will be bilateral stenosis based on the history and the clinical examination. By clinical examination, this is visible peristalsis and palpable mass. It's difficult to palpate this mass actually, but you can palpate it after the vomiting immediately. So, it will be non-specific measure. You have to accept the cork up and started antibiotic. So, this is in summary or home message. The assessment of this baby, it will be common in boys, more 4 to 5 times the girls. And there is genetic link, and strongly it will be maternal, related to the mother, جاي من الستات, related to maternal. CSS symptom and sign, the patient will present it in 3 weeks to 3 months. It will present with projectile non-bilious vomiting. And actually it will be baby after feeding, after vomiting, it will be very hungry baby, even being fed, even after you give feed, he will be more hunger. The weight, it either it weight loss or he's not weight gain. Either his weight, it was at birth it was 3 kg, and he maybe he lost his weight, it will be 2 kg, or he will be static and he's 3 weeks. It will be at birth it's 3 kg, and now after 3 weeks it also same, three is not gaining weight, or might lose weight. And also by this is the history, by clinical examination you have to palpate the olive mass, it will be in the gastric area, and also you have to visible inspection for the peristalsis moving, it will be left quadrant, from left quadrant area up to the epigastric, and the laboratory it will be hypochloremic, because the patient is vomit, this is the chloride and the hydrogen, so it will be hypochloremic, hypokalemic, metabolic what? Metabolic alkalosis, so the potassium it will be low and chloride it will be low, and the baby it will be having constipation, dehydration and hypoperfusion, and sometimes it will be shocked or hypovolemic shock. This is the symptom and sign. The pathophysiology, it will be actually there is hyperplasia or hypertrophy of the circular and longitudinal muscle layer of the pylorus, and this leading to what? Narrowing of the pyloric lumen. Narrowing of the pyloric lumen, it will be elongated more than 14 millimeter, and thickness it will be more than 4 millimeter. Normal thickness less than 2 millimeter, and normal length it will be less than 10. If more than 14 the length or and the thickness more than 4 millimeter, this is diagnostic for SHIPS. We call it congenital hypertrophic infantile pyloric stenosis. Impression or investigation, first of all, good history and examination. Your impression based on what? Your impression, it will be based on your assessment or your evaluation or professional diagnosis. It will be based on good history. You take good history and also examination. Examination, inspection, palpation. Inspection for the peristalsis, the B. First B, peristalsis, and palpable B, palpable mass, palpable olive mass. This is from hypertrophy muscle from the contractions. And also you have to request for lab investigation, CBC and the blood sugar and electrolyte. It will be hypochloremic metabolic alkalosis. And also you have to request for blood gas to looking for the alkalosis. And you have to test the feet and ultrasound. And barium is very rare you requested. It will show the shoulder sign, we call it barium, it will see the shoulder sign, but in ultrasound it will be diagnostic. Ultrasound it will be diagnostic. The other GI or barium meal, it will be only in the case of atypical presentation or the ultrasound is not suggestive. The ultrasound is not suggestive. How to treat this patient? 5N. First of all, medical and surgical. Medical and surgical. And this is medical emergency. So N, it will be NBO, NGT free drainage, just to ventilate the stomach. You decompress the stomach and prevent aspiration. Why we are putting NGT? This is the reason why we are inserting NGT. The third N, it will be normal saline. Based on normal saline, it will give you a clue about the hydration. The hydration, rehydrate the baby. You have to treat the dehydrations. And also you have to treat the shock, the hypoperfusion, you have to give shock therapy, and also the deficit and the maintenance based on the degree of the dehydration or based on the patient shocked or not shocked. The other end, it will be notify the surgeon. This is a surgical case. You have to notify to come to assess the baby and evaluate the baby. He would like to do some examination or investigation or imaging study. And the last end, it will be non-specific measure like looks like the take septical cup and started antibiotic. So you have to treat any fluid balance. And you have to insert NGT. Why NGT? We said for decompress, ventilate the stomach to prevent the aspiration. And the surgical management, it will be what? Ramstead pyloromyotomy. Pyloro, this is a pylorus. And myo, this is a muscle. Otomy, this is mean dissection, or you make it release the stenosis or the narrowing of the pylorus. Muscle is the cut, but not the mucosa, and can be done open, and can be done open, and can even can do by laparoscopic, or there is some specific procedures the surgeon he will deal with it. And medical treatment with atropine sulfate is showing promising result. Atropine sulfate, there is studies is going about the atropine sulfate, it can helpful in such cases. So the treatment, it will be medical treatment and surgical treatment. activated. Medical 5 in NPO, NGT free drainage, and normal saline as rehydrations and acid base balance, correct acid base balance, and also you have to notify the surgeon, and you have to get non-specific septic workup started antibiotic. So this is the summary and the home message from the case. You have to assess the baby clinically, history and clinical assessment, inspection, palpation, and you have to request for lab studies or lab investigations looking for hypokalemic metabolic alkalosis and paradoxical aciduria, and also you have to request for ultrasound. It will be diagnostic specificity and sensitivity almost 100%. It will diagnose what congenital hypertrophic infantile paroxysmal cholecystitis chaps. It will be elongated the channel or the canal of the pylorus. It will be more than 14 millimeter, and the thickness it will be more than 4 millimeter is diagnostic. If cannot suggest by ultrasound, you can request an upper GI if atypical cases or the ultrasound is not suggestive. And also you have to request for electrolyte, acid, and ABG, and you have to test the baby for palpable mass. This is call it olive mass and peristalsis. And the treatment, it will be medical and surgical. Medical NBO, NGT free drainage, and normal saline. Notify the surgeon, non-specific measure, septic workup, started antibiotic, and surgical pyloromyotomy. This is common question in during the exam. What is the name of the type of the surgery for congenital paroxysmal? It will be Ramstead pyloromyotomy. Pyloro, this is pylorus. Myo, this is the muscle because hypertrophied muscle. Otomy, this means I will cut. Otomy, this means the cutting or dissection of this hypertrophied muscle, but not the mucosa. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا, سلام عليكم.